She said she'd kill it. Good evening, and welcome to Black Bear Nation, your source for University of Maine sports. I'm David Nickerson. Tonight, we have a recap of the past week and a half of Black Bear athletics, starting on the ice. Men's hockey lost last night to Boston College 5-2. Ben Bishop and Dave Wilson split time in the net. Wilson got the start, but gave up four goals. In relief, Ben Bishop shut out the Eagles. Scoring for Maine were Josh Soares, Keenan Hobson, with Soares adding an assist along with Billy Ryan, Brett Tyler, and Keith Johnson. The Bears hope to bounce back tonight in Chestnut Hill, Mass. Looking back to last week, both men's and women's hockey took on Vermont. The men played at the Alphonse while the women traveled to Burlington. The result was the same, as Maine did not discriminate, sweeping both sexes, outscoring Vermont 13-4. The men were without Ben Bishop and needed Dave Wilson to step up to the plate, and boy did he step up.
Here's Wilson taking one in the gut, one of his 32 saves on the night. And Josh Soares goes near post under the glove. Maine would take the lead 1-0. As Keenan Hobson makes it 2-0 on this wrister from the outside. Maine had 4 power play goals in the game. Then Mike Lundin wanted in on the action. This slapper blasts by Vermont's Joe Fallon. Here's another look at Lundin, off the pass by Levi. Then Lundin again, from the same spot with the wrister. He'd fall short of the hat trick, but Fallon would get pulled later in the game. And then a crazy trick shot that didn't work was attempted by Billy Ryan. Oh, he's gonna grow up and be a lacrosse player.
He is.
Maine would go on to win 5-1 and 1-0 the next day.
To 9-17-1 with the two wins. Scoring was led by Sundstrom with 2 goals. Vanny, Peacock, Corvo, and the Law Sisters each had 1. Men's basketball. The Maine's team had been anticipating a rematch with America East number 1 Vermont to prove that the 69-64 win last month was not a fluke. But the Black Bears would have to get by number 2 Albany first. The Bears had won 6 of the last 7 coming into last week, while Albany was on a 7-game winning streak. Something had to give.
Maine's Kevin Reed was coming off a 15-point game in a win at New Hampshire and was looking to help the Black Bears knock off Albany. In the first possession of the game, Reed drives baseline, up and over the big man, off the glass and in for 2. Maine would take a 5-0 lead and hold Albany to 0 points in the first 5 minutes, thanks to 4 steals, including this one by Chris Bruff. More on him later. But the lead slipped away as Albany's Brian Lewis knocks down one of the team's 7 3-pointers. If the game were a dunk contest, however, Maine would have clearly won, as Lewis pulls a Woody Harrelson here. No, white man, you can't jump. Bruff, on the other hand, he's got game. Booyah shaka. See it again and again and again. Maine, in the end, could not hold off Albany, as Brent Wilson knocks down the tray in the final minute. Albany went on to win 71-55.
The Black Bears fell to Binghamton on Sunday in Vestal, New York, in their worst offensive output of the year. Maine put only 40 points on the board. The back-to-back losses would make a win versus Vermont on Wednesday so much sweeter. Outside there was a blizzard, but inside Alphonse Arena, Maine was retiring Rufus Harris's number 20. Harris is Maine's all-time leading scorer with 2,206 points. He holds 10 UMaine records and was inducted into the Maine Sports Hall of Fame in 1991.
Vermont traveled to Maine on Wednesday, taking with them the lead in America East, having only one conference loss, that being to the Black Bears. UMaine looked strong in the first half. Off this missed 3, Chris Bruff gathers up the rebound, looks down court, and finds Junior Bernal, who lays it in for 2 of his 14 points. Here's Bernal again, making a nifty spin move and dropping it down. But Vermont was too strong on the boards with a 6'11", 270-pound giant cleaning up after missed shots. Catamounts would run away with this one, despite the efforts of Bruff, who scored a team-high 21 points. Maine lost its third game in a row, 90-75, falling to 11-15 overall.
When we return, we'll see how the women fared on the court this week. Stay with us. You're watching Black Bear Nation on the Maine Channel.
basketball team took on Binghamton Saturday, a day filled with great music and many mascots. A slew of high school bands were at the game, and this Tiger was having a ball. On to the game. Binghamton came out firing. It seemed that every shot they took would go down. Right off the jump ball, Binghamton controls it, and they get it into Lorisario. Takes it into the paint, and lays it in for two. Down low, Lane Kerpnes. Up and under. Franceschi. Money. Sario again. Buckets. Then it gets downright ugly as Rebecca Lindgren throws up a prayer and her prayers are answered. That can't happen again, can it? 1 second on the shot clock. And let's pause it here for a second. And look at Coach McInerney. She's obviously confused because she's not hearing anybody call the bank. And if you don't call the bank, the shot doesn't count, people. But Maine would hang on. Pass from Yoni to Green up to three. And then with the shot clock winding down, Gracie Barker takes it top of the key, drains the tray. Maine would use their size down low as Green gets it into Vecude, who lays it in for two of her ten. Off the inbound, Barker's looking for someone to pass it to. You know what? I'll just school this chick left-handed. What you want for free? Maine was down by one with under 5 minutes to go when a big play changed the game. Off the rebound, Green takes it down the court and she's got numbers. Looking to get it into the paint, but wait, kick it back out. Underwood? Oh, you're so money and you don't even know it. Maine would keep the lead until the end. Here's Chris Yonan with a little insurance. Taking it southpaw. That's Shottown skills right there, people. The Black Bears ended up winning 59-56.
Vermont on Tuesday, despite Underwood posting 20 points, Maine blew a 6-point lead at halftime. They'll be busy in practice this week for sure. Men's and women's swimming and diving competed in the America East Championships last Sunday. 9 school records were broken, while the men finished 5th overall, with the women placing 4th. Jesse Ellis Alcade broke the record for the 100 free with a time of 52.06 seconds. Colleen Miller annihilated 2 school records for the 1650 and 1000 yard. She finished almost 17 seconds faster than the previous record for the 1650. On the men's side, the 200 yard breast record was broken 3 separate times. Chris Card set the new time in the prelims, followed by Nathan Richard breaking that time as well in the prelims. Richard would then go on to break his own time in the finals. Final time stands at 205.67.
Softball held an exhibition game versus UMass Lowell last weekend in the Mahaney Dome. The women looked pretty sharp on defense as they catch this pop fly and then double off Julie Brody on first. Here's a great play by Tara Velardo. She beats out the bunt single, racing down the first baseline, showing a little hustle. But you know what? She's got a little more than hustle. She's got smarts. She sees the pitcher turn her back. See you later! Taking off the second. And there's nothing you can do about it. Very, very, very sneaky, sir. Yes, indeed. Now let's pick it up with the bases juiced for Kristen Calvetti. She's going to take this high heat deep sauce off the wall. Count it, folks. That's a grand slam. Maine would go on to win 5-1. And their season opener is this weekend in Kentucky. Maine was projected number 3 in the latest America East preseason poll.
You may know Errol Gordon as the starting tailback for the football team. Last year, he led the team in rushing and receiving and scored 8 touchdowns. That season has come and gone now. Gordon is showing us on the track that he can run just as fast without a football. During last week's Valentine's Invitational, the men's track and field had strong outings from many students. Gordon claimed first place in the 55-meter run and 3rd overall in the 200-meter, breaking a school record. Donald Drake placed 13th in the mile run, with Miles Bartlett behind him in 24th. The team relay consisted of Drake, Bartlett, Scott O'Connor, and Eric Libby. They placed 3rd in the competition, setting a new school record with a time of 9:56.51. Jeff Ramos placed 10th in the high jump, skying 1.93 meters. In women's track, top performers included Vanessa Letourneau, Stephanie Jett, and Aaron Hatch. The top field performers consisted of Hatch, Allison Thomas, Rachel McCaslin, and Tess Perry. Stick around. We have some big news about Mr. Irrelevant, and is that victory I smell? It's been since January 5th. Details ahead. Kevin McMahon, known as Mr. Irrelevant in the 2006 NFL Draft, may be catching passes from a Super Bowl MVP. No, he didn't sign with the Patriots. He signed with the freshest MVP, Peyton Manning and the Colts. McMahon is headed from the worst team in the league, the Raiders, to the team who won the Super Bowl. Good choice on his part. Big news coming out of Boston. The Celtics finally picked up their 13th win of the season Wednesday night. Gerald Green was hot from beyond the arc, going 5-for-5. Pierce contributed 32 points as the Seas ended their 18-game losing streak, beating the Bucks 117-97. A lot of Maine teams have hit the road this week, but women's hockey has a pair of games this weekend you shouldn't miss. The Black Bears take on BU Saturday and Sunday, beginning at noon. I hope you enjoyed the first 2007 episode of Black Bear Nation. Be sure to tune in next Friday for all your University of Maine sports needs. I'm David Nickerson, and you're watching the Maine Channel. Have a safe weekend. Peace.